Hiding under the bonnet of this very ordinary looking version of the new Mazda 3 hatch is what I reckon to be the most exciting technological advancement of my career. And the only telltale signs are this badge and a couple of bigger exhaust pipes. No, it's not a hydrogen fuel cell or even an electric motor, but rather the production version of the Skyactiv-X compression ignition petrol engine I drove in prototype form nearly 2 years ago. And now I'm back in Germany to test drive the final version. What's compression ignition again? It's basically how a diesel engine works, by using extreme pressure instead of spark plugs to burn fuel. Skyactiv-X still uses spark plugs, but only to kick off the ignition process and act as a safety net for cold starts, etc., while extreme compression makes for much more effective combustion. This means the engine can use a much leaner fuel-to-air mixture and make more power on torque with less fuel, and it's a world first to make it all work with a production petrol engine. There's also a supercharger thrown into the mix, and very complex sensors control the whole show to deliver diesel-like torque and fuel consumption with the power and refinement of a petrol. It also represents a continuation of core principles we've seen from the start of Mazda's Skyactiv era. That is, to make an existing engine type work better under everyday driving conditions. And if you're looking for more detail, read the full review on the CarsGuide site and hit like and subscribe to stay on top of all our latest videos. This might sound a bit sci-fi to you, but you'll hopefully be able to get it in Australia before the end of the year as a new top spec Mazda 3, and then you'll be able to get it in the sedan or the hatch or the auto or the manual. When I drove the prototype version of this drivetrain, it was wrapped in the body of the old Mazda 3 on top of the chassis of the new Mazda 3 to disguise just how special it all is. The engine was most of the way there then, but there was a slight pinging as it transitioned between spark ignition and compression ignition under light throttle. I'm pleased to confirm that after 2 years of extra calibration, they've tuned this down to the tiniest occasional diesel sound, and it all really feels like a diesel engine that's much quieter and more responsive than you expect. Mazda is making two versions of the Skyactiv-X 2-litre, one designed for Europe that favours premium unleaded petrol, and one aimed at the US with their abundance of lower grade unleaded. Unlike conventional engines, it's the lower compression version that will deliver the best benefits, because Skyactiv-X relies on the usually bad thing, pinging, to do its best. We're driving the Euro-spec version we're set to get in Australia, which unfortunately means we won't quite be getting the very best Skyactiv tech again. The Euro-spec engine puts out 132 kilowatts and 224 newton metres, which on paper sounds about halfway between the three's existing 2 and 2.5 litre engines, but in reality feels closer to the 2-litre in performance. My perception is likely to be clouded by the Skyactiv-X's specific transmission gearing, but it could also be because it's able to do the same job with less revs. Mazda has done an amazing job of making the two ignition types, the supercharger and massive compression, work so effectively you can hardly tell anything different is happening under the bonnet. Unlike most big technological advancements, this isn't about extra performance or reinventing the wheel. It's about Mazda's bigger picture approach to deliver the best mobility solutions for right now, while still planning for electric and fuel cell vehicles in the future. Our final judgment will have to wait till we know how much it costs over a regular 3, but for now I can tell you that it works really well and should really suit Australian conditions. And don't forget, if you're looking for more detail, you can read the full review on the CarsGuide site and hit like and subscribe to stay on top of all our latest videos.